Hello everybody, today we are going to see some problems which are dependent on the quadrilateral and parallelogram. Okay, already we have seen theorem which are dependent on the parallelogram. Okay, so first problem is, in a parallelogram ABCD, angle D is equal to 115 degree. Determine the measure of angle A and angle B. Okay, very simple question. Once again, see, in a parallelogram ABCD, suppose parallelogram ABCD, angle D is equal to 115 degree. Determine the measure of angle A and angle B. Okay, we have to find out these two angles. So we know that the angles on the same side of transversal are supplementary, or consecutive angles of parallelogram are supplementary. Okay, so angle A plus angle B is equal to 180. So according to that, we can take here angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Angle A plus D equals to 180 degree. From that, angle B is known, that is 150 degree. So directly we can put here angle A plus 150 degree is equal to 180. Okay, so angle B is equal to 180 minus 150. 180 minus 150. So angle A is equal to 65 degree. Angle A is equal to 65 degree. Okay, so angle A we got 65 degree. And as we know, opposite angles of parallelogram are always same. So they are asking angle B also. So B we can write directly 150 degree. Okay, opposite angle. Or else we can do 65, A plus B is equal to 180 degree. Anyhow we can do. So directly I can do angle B is equal to angle D is equal to 65 degree. Sorry, 115 degree. 150 degree. These both angles are opposite angles. So this is 150, so this is also 150. This is 65, so angle C is also 65. Okay? Okay, see here, our second problem is, ABCD is a parallelogram and line segment AX and XCY bisect the angles A and C respectively. Show that AX is parallel to CY. Figure is given. Once again, see, ABCD is a parallelogram. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. Then, and line segment AX and CY bisect the angles A and C respectively. AX bisect angle A and CY bisects angle C. Okay, means here we can say this angle 2 and this angle is equal, as well as angle 1 and this angle is equal. Okay, now we have to prove that, show that AX is parallel to CY. This AX and CY are parallel to each other, that we have to show. Okay, so parallel to each other is what? Either here see, angles are given 1, 2 and 3. If we are able to show angle 1 and angle 3 are equal, angle 1 and angle 3 are equal, then we can say corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. If corresponding angles are equal, lines are parallel. Okay. So we need to show angle 1 and 3 equal. Okay. So for that, again here, we can use the property of parallelogram. Okay. As we know, opposite angles of parallelogram are always equal. So here we can say angle A is equal to angle C. Okay, so that I am taking first here in solution. Angle A is equal to angle C. Why? Opposite angles of parallelogram. Opposite angles of parallelogram are always equal. Angle A and angle C are equal. Now, if you will take half of this, half of angle A, that time we need to take half of angle C. So half of angle A is equal to half of angle C. Both the sides we have multiplied by half, or we have taken half of both the sides. Okay, so half of angle A. So half of angle A is equal to angle 1. Okay, and half of angle C is equal to the angle 2. Because this CY is the bisector of angle C, and AX is the bisector of angle A. So we can say half of angle A is equal to angle 1, angle 1 is equal to half of angle C is equal to angle 2. Okay, so this we will say first. Angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Okay, now one more thing here, we need to think about AB and CD also. Okay, AB and CD, this pair is also opposite segment, these two are opposite to each other and that pair is parallel to each other. Okay, so here we can say AB is parallel to DC, AB is parallel to DC, that time CY is a transversal, CY is transversal, CY is transversal, okay, CY is transversal. So we can say if these two lines are parallel and CY is transversal, that time we can say angle 2 and angle 3 are equal, angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. Why? Alternate interior angles. Okay, when two lines are parallel lines are cut by transversal, that time alternate interior angles are equal. So according to that, we can see here angle 2 is equal to angle 3. Angle 2 and angle 3 are equal. So this I am saying second. Okay, here see our first result is angle 1 is equal to angle 2, but angle 2 is equal to angle 3. So we can say angle 1 and angle 3 are equal. Angle 1 and angle 3 are equal. So directly I can say here angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3 from first and second. From 1 and 2 I can say angle 1 and angle 3 are equal. Okay. So now after this, angle 1 and angle 3 are corresponding angles. Okay. If corresponding angles are equal, that time you can say lines are parallel. Okay, angle 1 and angle 3, we can write here, angle 1 and angle 3 are corresponding angles also, corresponding angles also, and both, and they are same, they are equal. So we can say, if corresponding angles are equal, we can say AX is parallel to CO, AX is parallel to CO, okay. Okay, see here, our next problem is, given triangle ABC, lines are drawn through A, B and C parallel respectively to the sides BC, CA and AB, forming triangle PQR. Show that BC is equal to half of Q. Okay, see once again here, given that triangle ABC is given, lines are drawn through A, B and C, through A, this is from B and from C, okay, respectively to the sides BC, CA and AB, BC and CA and AB forming triangle PQR, okay. Now show that BC is equal to half of QR, BC is equal to half of QR. Okay, here one important thing is through A, B and C parallel lines are drawn, that is important. Okay, so here first we will think about this. What is given here? AQ, this is parallel to CB, CB and RQ are parallel. Okay, so that we can take first CB is parallel to RQ, CB is parallel to RQ. Okay, then we can say CB is parallel to AQ, CB is parallel to AQ, CB and AQ are parallel. Then we can say AC is parallel to BQ, AC is parallel to BQ. We are thinking about quadrilateral AQBC. Okay, we are thinking about quadrilateral AQBC. So first we have seen AQ is parallel to BC, which is given. Then we can say CA is parallel to BQ, CA is parallel to BQ. Okay, if opposite sides, pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other, that time you can say that is a parallelogram. So we can see here AQBC, quadrilateral AQBC is a parallelogram. AQBC is a parallelogram. Okay, if this is parallel term, opposite sides are equal, we can say, so here we can write AQ is equal to BC. If AQ is equal to BC. Okay, so now AQ is equal to BC. This is first one. Why? Opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Opposite sides of parallelogram are always equal. So we told here AQ and BC are equal. Okay. Now we will think about next quadrilateral, that is ABCR or ARBC. Okay. So now here also we can say AR parallel to BC. Okay. So that we can mention here AR parallel to BC. AR is parallel to BC and AB is parallel to RC. AB is parallel to RC. AB and RC are parallel to each other. Okay. So if opposite sides are parallel to each other, then that also ARBC, ARCB, quadrilateral ARCB is also a parallelogram. Is also parallel. Okay. So here we can tell AR is equal to BC. AR is equal to BC. AR is equal to BC. Okay, AR and BC are equal. Okay, why? Because again the same reason which we are going to see second one, opposite sides of parallelogram. Opposite sides of parallelogram are equal. Okay, so now first one is AQ is equal to BC. AR is equal to BC. So from first and second we can say AQ is equal to AR. AQ is equal to AR. From first and second we can say AQ is equal to AR. This AQ and AR are equal. These two sides are equal. Okay, AQ is equal to AR. So from this, here we can write from 1 and 2. Okay, AQ and AR are equal, then we can say AQ is equal to half of QR. AQ, I can write AQ is equal to half of QR. Half of QR means what? AR or AQ also we can say. Understood? So AQ is equal to half of QR, but AQ is equal to BC. AQ is equal to BC. So we can replace this AQ by BC. So BC is equal to half of QR. BC is equal to half of QR. And that would be they are asking. Understood? Everybody? So here first we have to prove that this quadrilateral. Quadrilateral AQBC is a parallelogram. If it is a parallelogram, then AQ and BC are equal. Then ARCB is a parallelogram. Then AR and CB are equal. So this is AQ is equal to half of QR. AQ we can replace by BC because AQ and BC are the opposite sides of each other. Opposite sides of parallelogram. Okay. So that are always equal. So BC is equal to half of QR. Okay. Okay. See here our next problem is in figure AN and CP are perpendicular to the diagonal BD of a parallelogram ABCD. Prove that triangle ADN congruent triangle CDP and AN is equal to CP. Okay. Two things they are asking us. Once again, see in figure AN and CP are perpendicular. AN and CP are perpendicular to the diagonal BD. BD is diagonal and BP and AN are perpendicular. Okay. Of a parallelogram ABCD. ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay. Prove that triangle ADN, 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 this triangle and congruent triangle CBP, this triangle, this and this triangle. These two triangles we have to show congruent. Okay. Now second question they are asking AN is equal to CP. If we will prove both the triangles are congruent, then automatically AN and CP will be same. By CPCD we can give that. So now we need to think how to show both the triangles are congruent. Okay. Here one thing is there, that is AD is parallel to BC as ABCD is a parallelogram. So that we can mention here, since ABCD is a parallelogram, ABCD is a parallelogram, then we can say AD is parallel to BC. AD and BC are parallel. Okay. And BD is transversal. BD is the transversal. Okay. AD and BC are parallel and BD is the transversal. So angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. Angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Alternate interior angles. Okay. Alternate interior angles are equal. Got it? So now one angle we have. Second thing we can say about this angle AND is equal to BPC, because both the angles, this angle and this angle is right, both angles are right angle. So that we can take, that is second, we can say this angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. So now directly we can use both the triangles. So this triangle ADN and triangle CBP. Okay, first thing, angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Alternate angles, this we will say first. So from 1, second AND angle AND is equal to angle BPC, angle BPC, both 90 degree or each 90 degree we can write. Okay, this is also 90 degree, this is also 90 degree. Then this angle AD and the BC sides are equal because opposite sides are parallel. Okay, so we can see here AD is equal to BC. Then here we can represent opposite sides of parallel. Opposite sides of parallel are equal. So we have two angles. We have two angles and one side. Two angles and one side. So by AAS, both the triangles are congruent. So here we can give triangle ADN congruent triangle CBP by AAS criteria or condition. Okay. Now triangles are congruent according to first question more. Then AN and CP are the two sides of the congruent triangles, corresponding sides. Okay. So directly we can say AN is equal to CP by CPCP. By CPCP, both AN and CP are equal. Okay? Thank you.